Students, I am Nandravalia. Today I will explain you how a lead acid battery works. Here is a lead acid battery, 32 Ah ampere hours and 12 volt, and it has 6 cells. Now I will explain you one of the cells on the board, how it works. Here it is, one cell. In this cell, there are some reactants. I have not shown any of the other parts. I have shown only the reactants. Now the first reactant is positive plate. Here it is. It is PbO2, lead dioxide, or also called lead peroxide. It is 1 mole. It is dark brown in color. It has 6.022 into 10 raised to the power 23 Avogadro number, means that much of molecules. Its weight is 239 grams. 207 grams is of the lead, and O2 has 32 grams. Next is second, the negative plate. It is lead. It is also one mole. It is 207 grams. It is gray in color. And there is number three is the electrolyte. It is acid and water. 36% of it is acid, H2SO4, sulfuric acid, by volume. And 64% by volume is the water, H2O, 214 milliliter. This is 120 milliliter because the H2SO4 has the density 1.84, so its weight will be more, 220.8 gram. But the density of the water is 1, so it has 214 gram. The total mass of the reactants will be 880.8 gram. So the density of a fully charged battery is 1.3. But the acid is 36% because it is by volume, and this comes into weight also. Weight has to be considered. Weight by volume comes the density 1.3. How do we measure it? Here we have got a hydrometer. This hydrometer is put into this glass tube. Because this glass tube sucks the, with the help of this rubber, it sucks the liquid into it, and we can measure what is the density of the thing. So here it is 1.3 at the most yellow, below the yellow is 1.3, and below the red is 1.15, and the battery is fully discharged. Means from that limit, not that fully discharged. Now here comes how, what happens in the chemical reaction. In the chemical reaction, I have taken one molecule of lead dioxide. Here it is, lead dioxide, and two molecules of H2SO4, two H2SO4. And one atom of lead. Now at 2H2SO4 in the water, when it is dilute, it reacts and separates into parts. What parts are these? It will create four hydrogen cations. Cations being positive charges. And 2SO4, this will be sulfates, and they will be negatively charged, these two I have taken these two so that I can show you the different actions on positive plate and negative plate. This is a radical and it reacts very quickly because there are two extra electrons on it and they react very quickly with the mix. Now what happens the next? This O2 of the lead dioxide will make react with four hydrogen atoms and will produce two molecules of water, 2H2O. Now this lead plus two of the positive charges and two of the negative charges of the sulfate will react and produce lead sulfate. It will be white in color and there will be two positive charges, 2E1 on the positive plate. And on the negative side, SO4, this sulfate is negatively charged. It will react with the lead and it will also make it lead sulfate. But there will be two extra charges, negative charges. These negative charges will charge the negative plate. And how this action takes place? This action takes very quick because average speed of electrolyte molecules here in it is from 100 meter per second in the heavy molecules to 590 meter per second to the water molecules. So this process goes on. When this plates are at 2 volt are on the cell terminals, the reaction will stop because a positive plate will reject more positive charges and a negative plate will reject the negative charges and there will be no reaction. Chemical reaction will stop. But if we connect this positive terminal to this negative terminal through a circuit or a conductor, the current will flow. Let us see how does it happen. Here it is. This is a positive, this is negative, and here it is a circuit, a bulb of 3 watt. Now you can see this. If we continuously use this battery will go on discharging. The potential difference on these points will go down and the reaction will start again. And as the reaction will start, the battery will be discharged. But we are not going to discharge the battery completely, because if we completely discharge the battery, we will not be able to revive it. So now after the battery comes to the density 1.15 red point as I shown you in the hydrometer, the reactants, what are the reactants in it? There will be lead dioxide 87 gram and lead sulfate will be 193 gram and the two will be 280 grams. And it means that it will become heavier from 239 gram to 280 gram. And this negative plate, this will be 75 gram of the lead and lead sulfate will be 193 gram. And as a result, it will get 268 grams of weight. So from 207 gram, this its weight will increase and from gray it will become a grayish white and this will be brownish white, from brown to brownish white. And what happens to the H2SO4? H2SO4 will become less. So the density of this electrolyte will go down to 1.15. At that time the H2SO4 will come to 52 milliliter from 120 milliliter. It will become 18% and there will be some 2H2 added that will be 23 gram, and the result will be 214 milliliter plus 23, and result will be 237 milliliter. But this liquid will become a little less, because this liquid is 334, but this liquid will be 237 plus 52 will be 289. So the level of the liquid will go down in it. And now we calculate that before the action started, it was 180.8 gram total reactant's mass. But again, the reactant's mass will be 880.8 gram. Only the difference will be, there will be more solids and less liquid. Now, how much energy we will get from it? Electric charges produced. We have used 220.8 gram of H2SO4 to 95.8. So we have used 125 grams of and the one mole of H2SO4 is 98. So by multiplying it with the Avogadro number, we get 125 by 98 into this. This will be the charges, but if we divide it by Coulomb's charge, 6.22 into 10 raised to the power 18, we get the Coulombs. How many Coulombs we will get? We will get 123,490 Coulombs. And this Coulombs, if we pass through a circuit, then if these charges, one Coulomb charges pass in 1 second, then it will produce 1 ampere. Now we multiply, divide it by 60 into 60 means 1 hour. So we will get 34 ampere hour capacity. But this is 2 volts. This is amperes hour current. But if we multiply it by 2 volt, we will get the energy 68 watt hour. That is the energy that will be produced by this system. But if we go on discharging this battery, all the H2SO4